Just because you're ugly.
Ugly? You gotta be kidding me.
Greetings, baby bats. My name is Roncy. I am a grandmother and a goth. I'm 59 years old, and I have 2 baby bat granddaughters. So today I'm going to talk to you about dance floor etiquette. So when you are on the dance floor and you are defending your dance space, which many of us do with our arms, this is my dance space, this is my dance space, this is my dance space, watch where you're going. And if you accidentally whack your neighbor in the face, make sure that you say sorry. They can't hear you, but if you mouth it, you should be okay. Secondly, when du hast comes on, make sure that you know where your feet are going when you stomp. You don't want to stomp on someone's toes with your new rocks, your demonias, your steel-toed boots. It's just not nice. So have fun out there and bless your sweet dark heart.
Hey, I think I don't belong here. I think I was supposed to go to the other place.
Show me how you do that.
Oh, I get it now.
Trying different alt makeup styles until I find one I fuck with. Trad Goth. Let's do brows. Fill them in, blend, and conceal them to carve them out. And be sure to set with brow gel. Prime with a white primer and pack with white shadow to get a good base. And then we're gonna do foundation. I mix 2 shades to get mine. I conceal for extra coverage. Bake your under eyes to catch fallout and set your whole face with powder. I start drawing out my eye shape with black shadow before I do the liner and smoke out the outer corner. Then use white liner to lower my waterline. I continue smoking the black shadow out and add white shimmer for a little dimension. And then I go in with my liner. I end up filling in my brow, and you want to make sure that you have some pretty sharp shapes. Finish your eyes off with mascara and lashes. Black lipstick, teased hair, and a lacy top finishes off the look. And now you're a bad bitch.
So I found the perfect air freshener for my new car. Ah yes, new hearse smell. And it goes perfect with my bat.
Bitches be like, I'm so slept on, but be looking like this.
I don't cook, I don't clean, but let me tell you, I got this ring.
Gobble me, swallow me, drip down inside of me, quit, jump out for you, let it get inside of me. I tell him where to put it, never tell him where I'm about to be. I run down on him before I have a nigga running me. Talk your shit, bite your lip, ask for a call while you ride that dick. You really ain't.
Hello, so this is kind of like a get ready with me slash makeup tutorial sort of thing. So I start off the morning by shaving my eyebrows yet again. And this is literally just because I prefer to draw them on. And I wash my face, brush my teeth, and these are like my cool little chests that I keep jewelry and makeup in. I thought that was fun to show you. These are my contacts that I got from SPSI, and then I put on some facial primer, and I use a powder that I got literally from Spirit Halloween. And a lot of people always ask me why I put on eyeshadow primer and eyeshadow before I put on my eyeliner. That's just because it makes it stay longer. I have very oily eyelids, and I found that the only way to keep the eyeliner on and to keep it thick is to put eyeshadow on first, for some reason. I'm sorry, but I forgot to film while I was doing my eyebrows, but you know, it's pretty much just a thin line. And I draw my Cupid's bow on pretty sharp just because I prefer it that way. And I washed my hair this morning, so I tried to use minimal product in it, but there's only so much I can do with that. That's what I smell like, and I just put on my outfit and fangs, and I'm finished.
Hi, I have no idea when or where I will be able to wear this dress, but just know that when I finally do get to wear this dress in public, I will be breaking hearts and nobody will be safe. I will be a danger to society.
Pink Ferragamo sliders on deck. Silly rap beefs just get me more checks. My life is a movie, I'm never offset. Me and my amigos, no, not offset. Swish, swish, ah, I got them upset. But my shooters, I make them dance like dubstep. Swish, swish, ah, my haters is obsessed. Cause I make...
That's just because it makes it stay longer. I have very oily eyelids, and I found that the only way to keep the eyeliner on and to keep it thick is to put eyeshadow on first, for some reason. I'm sorry, but I forgot to film while I was doing my eyebrows, but you know, it's pretty much just a thin line. And I draw my Cupid's bow on pretty sharp just because I prefer it that way. And I washed my hair this morning, so I tried to use minimal product in it, but there's only so much I can do with it. That's what I smell like, and I just put on my outfit and fangs, and I'm finished.
Here's a little game I like to call Emo Band Name or SpongeBob Episode Title. Let's play. Number one is City Cop. SpongeBob Episode or Emo Band? That's right, it was an Emo Band. Pretty easy one. Let's go again. Next up we got Can't Swim. SpongeBob Episode or Emo Band? You got it. Another Emo Band. Ready to play again? Next up is Pre-Hibernation Week. SpongeBob episode or Emo Band? That's right, our first SpongeBob episode. Good job. Let's go again. Okay, next up we have Artist Unknown. SpongeBob episode or Emo Band? Ooh, tough one, but it was a SpongeBob episode. Let's go one more. Okay, last one, quick. Unwed Sailor. SpongeBob episode or Emo Band? Another goddamn Emo Band.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it. And this will make me TikTok famous. Yeah, for some reason, they like it when it comes out of your mouth and not mine.
Imagine, like, trying to kiss me. I know. Whoo, stop that right there. But imagine, and I have to be like...
I used to glue stuff to my head.
This speech is my recital. I think it's very vital to rock
around.
That's right,
on top.
It's tricky. It's tight. Here we go. It's tricky to rock around. To rock around. That's right, on time. It's tricky. It's tricky.
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 This little girly, her hair was kinda curly.
It's time for another game of Emo Band Name or SpongeBob Episode Title. Feel free to duet and play along. Let's go. First up, we have Wet Painters. SpongeBob Episode or Emo Band? That would be a SpongeBob Episode. Let's move on. Up next, we have Worst Party Ever. SpongeBob or emo? That's right, an emo band. Next. Up next, we got Grand Fishing Opera. SpongeBob episode, emo band. That will be an emo band. Tough one. Up next, we got the Bad Guy Club for villains. SpongeBob episode, emo band. That will be a SpongeBob episode. Nice. Next, we got Sub Muscles. Emo band, SpongeBob episode. That will be an emo band. Okay, last one. Okay, last one, quick. Snail mail. Gotcha, bitch, it's both of them. This is your zodiac signs pop punk anthem.
It's the end of November, and I haven't done a no-no what's November yet. I love giving my unsolicited opinion online. It's like a hobby for me. In the spirit of giving, I'm gonna give you guys no-no what's November hot takes for the alternative community, but it's from a person of color's point of view because I have a lot to get off my chest. White people, you might wanna take notes. Firstly, there's a scary amount of alternative fashion that is just straight up cultural appropriation. Like, straight up, can't be alternative and conservative, because being alternative is having alternative ideas from the norm and rebelling against society, and society is racist, sexist, homophobic and transphobic, so it just doesn't really work. Here's the one that gets people angry. The alternative community at its core was built on cultural appropriation. Black people gave us rock music. It helped birth all the different subcultures, all the different genres. White people took it from them, whitewashed it, and then excluded them from it.
Back in 1987, my parents opened a clothing store called Fashionation. Together, they greatly impacted Denver's goth, punk, and alternative scene, giving everyone around them a safe place to shop, hang out, and be themselves. A few years later, I was born, then my sister. We became a full-on family business. Oh yeah, and we also hang out with rock stars all the time, but that's a story for another day. 27 years later, we had to move locations, so we packed up and kept the legacy going down on South Broadway. And we're still here to keep Denver rocking.